This is the Bresser Pollux 150-750mm telescope. This telescope is designed for observing as well as photographing the Moon, the Sun, and of course planets. If you're considering purchasing this telescope, this video is perfect for you, because in this video I'll show you exactly what you can achieve with this telescope and lunar astrophotography. If you're looking to get started, you may have noticed that most telescopes can be quite expensive. For a good setup in deep sky astrophotography, you often need to invest a few thousand euros to capture galaxies. Personally, I use another telescope for astrophotography. It consists of a Newtonian telescope mounted on the HEQ5 Pro Goji mount that can track objects. The camera I'm using is the Canon EOS 2000D. To control the telescope, I use the ASI Air Pro. As you can see, it's very complex and above all expensive. In this video, I'll demonstrate that impressive images can be captured with a telescope like this one too. The Bresser Pollux telescope has a focal length of 750mm and an aperture of 150, which results in a focal ratio of f5.0. The telescope itself is mounted on an EQ3 mount. To capture the Moon today, I'll be using a Canon EOS 2000D, but you can use a smartphone too. This is because the telescope comes with a smartphone adapter that allows you to connect your smartphone to the telescope. Last night, everything worked well and I was able to capture some videos of the Moon. The video you can see here was taken yesterday. Unfortunately, the seeing conditions last night were not that good. Some of you might now wonder why I made a video instead of taking single images. In planetary astrophotography, using videos instead of taking single images is preferred because it allows for capturing a large number of frames over an extended period of time. This is important because atmospheric conditions such as turbulence, for example, can vary very rapidly. By recording a video instead, you gather a continuous stream of frames, increasing the chance of capturing moments of perfect quality and especially sharpness, which is very important. Through a process called stacking, which we will be doing in the end, you can then select and combine the best frames of the video itself, effectively improving the overall quality of your final image in the end. I will now stack and edit the final image, but I won't discuss the editing process in this video, as this video focuses on the telescope itself. And with that, we have reached the end of this video. In summary, my experience with this telescope has been positive. One single negative aspect I've noticed is the mount itself. Especially when using a camera, it tends to be some kind of overloaded, causing the telescope to move while shooting the night sky. But aside from that, I'm generally very happy with this telescope and I would definitely recommend it. Still, it's important to mention that this telescope is not suitable for photographing deep sky objects such as galaxies or nebulae. So anyone hoping for images like the ones I'm currently displaying should definitely invest more money, because for astrophotography itself, a mount capable of tracking the night sky is needed. Sure, you can attempt it, but expect less impressive results compared to a better telescope. This telescope is more suitable for observing and photographing the Sun, the Moon, and of course planets. I will show the final image at the end of this video. Thank you so much for joining me in this video. If you enjoyed it, feel free to like this video. If you want to see more videos about this telescope or my journey in astrophotography itself, consider subscribing so you don't miss any future videos. If you're interested in more videos about the telescope, such as what else can be captured, how to set it up, and whether it's suitable for astrophotography by replacing the mount, leave a comment below this video. Otherwise, thank you so much for joining me, and until next time.